हेलो स्टूडेंट्स एंड वेलकम बैक टू बैंक एग्जाम स्टडी डॉट कॉम। सो SBI क्लर्क नोटिफिकेशन इज आउट। देर आर अराउंड 7200 वैकेंसीज। सो टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू टेल यू हाउ टू स्टार्ट योर प्रिपरेशन। सो टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू शेयर द एग्जैक्ट स्ट्रैटेजी टू क्रैक SBI क्लर्क प्रिलिम्स एग्जाम्स, राइट? सो विच बुक यू शुड फॉलो, वट टू डू, वट नॉट टू डू, हाउ टू मैनेज योर टाइम। सो टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस एवरीथिंग। सो लेट्स स्टार्ट विद द इंग्लिश सेक्शन। So students, everybody is going to recommend you to start reading newspapers. Everybody is going to tell you to read the Hindu, the Indian Express. Yes, this is the right suggestion actually. And then everybody will tell you the speed reading is important. Yes, it is important actually. But students, you need to understand that if you are not comfortable with speed reading, if you are not right now, you are not comfortable with speed reading, but if you are doing the speed reading, if you are trying to read the editorials quickly, then you are making a mistake, right? First of all, you need to understand the paragraphs. You need to understand the words. Gradually, I mean, with the time, you should start practicing the speed reading method actually, right? So that's how you should read the newspaper. In the beginning, for first 1 month, you should try to understand the paragraph. You should try to understand the news, right? Try to understand the difficult words. Gradually, you should practice the speed reading. That is the point number one for the reading comprehension, and actually for all the parts of the English section. So that is actually the most important part. In the exams, there are going to be reading comprehension out of 30 marks. There will be 10 questions from reading comprehension. Closed test there can be there, parajumble, spot the error, or spelling corrections, vocab, spelling correction, these kind of questions can be there. The reading comprehension, closed test and parajumble, normally they are story based. The most important factor is reading. So if you are reading a newspaper daily, try to understand whatever you are reading. So if you are just, you know, just going through it, right, then it is not beneficial at all. It is not beneficial at all. You need to try to understand what is written in the newspaper. So that is the point number one. What are the various books, you know, important for English? I recommend Renan Martin's book, right? The first of all, for the grammar, read Renan Martin's basic grammar concepts. Very important. There is Raymond Murphy's book for grammar. You can read that. But the most important factor here is you need to read the basic grammar concepts, right? The most important thing is read the basic grammar concepts. The second important thing here is you need to read a basic newspaper, either the Indian Express or the Hindu. That is actually important, right? So what next? What next for English? So what are the various important websites and books available? Go to bankexamstudy.com. There you can download the free reading comprehension ebooks. There you can download the free error spotting books. I will provide the links in the description. I have actually launched a free SBI clerk study material bundle. That package is available for free in the description. Just go to the description and download your copy. So then let's move on to quantitative aptitude, right? My forte. I wrote quantitative aptitude made easy. So see, in the quantitative aptitude section of SBI clerk, you need to have fast calculation speed. Your calculation speed should be really very fast. See, you need to solve 35 questions within 20 minutes, right? I mean, to clear the cutoff, you need to score at least 20 within 20 minutes. How you can do this? Obviously, you need to pick the easy questions. The number series questions are actually very easy. The simplification, approximation, these are questions are very easy. You can solve them within 1 minute per question. And then there are normally there are 2 to 3 data interpretation sets. Out of those 3 sets, normally one set is very easy, 1 or 2 sets are very easy, that you can solve within 5 minutes, and there are miscellaneous questions that are actually easy. So how to start your preparation for quantitative aptitude? First of all, the point number one, that you need to improve your calculation speed. How you can improve your calculation speed? The number one thing that you should do today is start reading try to memorize the tables up to 35, squares up to 30, cubes up to 20-25. Then learn the rule of fraction, very important. So if you don't know what is 12 over 19, how to calculate the value of 12 over 19, then it is very difficult to crack the exam. At least you should be good at finding the approximate value of the complex equations, right? See, for example, if I ask you what is the value of 623 divided by 900, so I want you to convert 623 over 900 into percentages. How to do that? You should be able to do that without using any pen or paper. Within 1 second, I should get reply from you. I should get an answer from you. So that is the most important part of the QT section. After having a strong base, you can start with the number series or the simplification and approximation, the most important chapter. I already made 3 lectures on simplification and approximation. I will provide you the links in the description. And further, for the number series, I have already done the video classes on number series. I will provide the links in the description. Then the data interpretation and table based questions are there again. So if your calculation speed is good, you can easily solve the data interpretation and table based questions, right? So the quantitative aptitude of preliminary exam. So if your speed, the calculation speed, your calculation speed is good, then you can easily score 20 marks within 20 minutes. If it is not that great, then it is very difficult for you. And let's move on to which books to follow. See students, I have provided the notes and the workbooks for quantitative aptitude section. For data interpretation, I have prepared 2 workbooks, and links to those workbooks are available in the description. You can download all these PDFs just free of cost. All you need to do is subscribe our channel. Just click the subscribe button. That's all I'm looking from you, right? So I want to reach the 100,000 number. So that's all you can do for me. Please subscribe the channel, and I'll continue, I'll keep on providing the great PDFs, the good study material to you. Just click the subscribe channel. That is very important for me and my team. So let's move forward. The notes are available in the description. The quantitative aptitude made easier, the data interpretation workbook. Actually, I have collected 188 questions from previous papers, right? And I have solved them, I have collected them, and I provided in the form of PDF. And that PDF is also available in the description. The link to the PDF actually. So the data interpretation, the number series, the quantitative aptitude shortcut tricks, the most important 200 questions PDF, everything is available in the description. Please download that. Let's move on to the reasoning part. See, in the reasoning, out of 30, there will be at least one sitting arrangement question and one puzzle at least. So total we can say that 15 marks are from puzzles and sitting arrangements. Normally the puzzles are very time consuming, facing inside out, very time consuming. It is very difficult to solve within 5 minutes, and also the puzzles are actually very difficult to solve within 5 minutes. The easy part of this paper is inequalities, alphanumeric series, or the miscellaneous questions like direction sense test, ranking, blood relations. Very easy to get marks out of these questions, right? So my strategy would be to solve the direction sense, ranking, blood relation, the inequalities, alphanumeric series questions first. And at the end of that paper, you should move on to the puzzle. So if you have just 20 minutes for the reasoning paper and you start with a puzzle and you just got a difficult puzzle, you'll end up wasting your 15 minutes and you got 0 marks, right? So instead of starting with puzzles, start with these miscellaneous questions like start with inequalities or alphanumeric series or direction sense, ranking or blood relation, you'll end up getting some marks. So it acts as an insurance, right? So for example, you are giving 10 minutes to inequalities series, in alphanumeric series, direction sensor, ranking of blood relations. You are getting like 12, 13 marks within 10 minutes. And for the next 10 minutes, pick the puzzles, or you can just pick the sitting arrangement. The PDF workbooks for the puzzles and the sitting arrangement, the separate workbooks are available in the description for free. You can download that, but for that you need to subscribe to our channel. Then for the inequalities, that PDF is also available for free. You can download. The link is available in the description. So I think that's all for the reasoning part. I have already provided you the study material. So again, there are some students who will ask me, what are the best books for the SBA clerk exam? Which book you should follow? For the English section, the best grammar book is by Renan Martin and Raymond Murphy. Those are the best books for grammar actually. For reading comprehension, the newspapers are there, right? I don't recommend any other book for the English section. Those are the best books, right? So for practice, I have provided the workbooks. You can download the workbooks from many n number of websites are available. You don't need to buy any book, right? For the quantitative aptitude section, again, I have provided the PDFs in case you want to buy a hard copy book. RS Agarwal is not that great. It is good, okay, but the questions are very basic. There are a lot of other books are available. I recommend Sarvesh Kumar Verma in all of my videos. You can get that, or the book by Arun Sharma is also great, also good. Those books are meant for CAT actually. So I don't think you need those books, right? For the clerical level exams, you don't need those books. You need to, you need to get speed, right? You need to solve the questions quickly, right? You are not going to find very difficult questions, but you need to have speed. You need to solve the questions quickly. For that, you need to practice a lot, as much as possible. So for the reasoning, again, I have provided the notes. A lot of good books available in the market, but our notes, the reasoning made easy, the notes available in the description are sufficient for SBI clerk exam. You don't need anything else. So students, just go to the description and download our notes. Even the premium bundle is also available. Just download that. So thank you. That's all for today. In case you have any problem, you don't understand anything, you can directly email me. My email ID is raman@bankexamstoday.com. My number is available in the description. That is 906720100. So that's all for today, students. Thank you and have a nice day and best of luck for your exams.